Guess he didn't.
Gentle breezes and sweet summer scents.
Birds twitter, butterflies dance,
and the shaggy sheep swam the green hills.
Plentiful and happy as the day was long.
It was called Pleasant Valley.
The shepherds used to spend their days watching over their flocks and telling stories about the days of the old.
Tell me more about the dragons, Father.
And there was a girl named Widget.
Ah, the dragons. Those were a nasty bunch, weren't they, Gilroy?
What were they like? Were they green and scaly?
That they weren't, girl.
Were they spiky and snarly?
Spikes all over. Snarly be bad.
And fire came out of their noses.
Like this?
Something like that, only hotter.
And they always spoke in poetry.
Poetry? I don't believe you.
It's true. Remember the one called Raggedy Bones?
Ah, he was a hungry dragon.
I enjoy eating young ones for dinner. I prefer fat ones to thinner. When they slide down my throat, they're as slippery as soap, and oh, what a taste they deliver.
They eat people?
Of course, especially like little boys, little girls like you.
Like me?
It's true. Remember one called Bristletip? I find the people around here bored just because they joke when I roar! I like spicier food, but they're easily chewed. I find they're a snack I adore.
What happened to them? Why aren't there any around here anymore?
Well, that's quite a storm, my lad. One day, a white knight.
By the name of George.
On a great sea, came galloping into town. I'll never forget his armor gleaming in the sun.
He carried a great lance. It must have been 10 feet long.
Some say he was a great hero home from the wars.
Some even say he was a saint.
Whatever he was a mighty dragon slayer.
Man, there is them extinct.
What do you mean extinct?
Never be seen again by God.
So I'll never get to see one like you did?
You should take your lucky stars for that, lad.
Because they're the meanest,
slimiest, most head-choppingest creatures you ever care to meet.
And if there were a dragon around these parts?
Say lurking in a shallow pond?
Like the one over there?
Or hiding in the brambles of the bushes?
The brambles of the bushes?
Or hibernating in one of those caves over there?
The caves over there?
Only to get rid of him, but to be.
To charge him.
To thrash him.
To kill him.
To run him through.
Hi-ya!
Oh, yay!
Well, better be getting home for dinner.
That's it, that's all there is. I want to hear more.
What's the missus cooking, Angus?
Mutton stew.
Oh, man.
My favorite.
That's all we ever have is mutton stew.
Casey's eating on Earth.
Now don't be late for dinner, Widget.
Come on, lamb chop.
Widget was certain that her life was destined to be the most boring life her god ever lived.
I know what I'd do if I ever saw a nasty old dragon. I'd say, "Well, dragon, I'm Widget, the mighty white knight dragon slayer. What makes you think that you're so big, scaly, fire-breathing?"
Just then, Widget's only friend came scampering down the hill.
Hey, Widget.
His name was Harry Toes.
It's Harry, H-A-R-R-Y, short for Henry.
Which was unfortunate.
You can call me Hank. I'm fine with Hank.
Because everyone called him Harry Toes.
Whatever. Hey, Harry Toes.
Hey, Widget, guess what I found?
Another squirrel, a bunny rabbit, big deal.
Oh, well, I guess you wouldn't be interested.
What is it?
Oh, nothing but a polar bear, that's all.
There aren't any polar bears in Pleasant Valley.
Did I say polar bear? I meant rhinoceros. Yeah, that's it, a great big rhinoceros with feet this big.
Will you stop making things up?
Well, the truth is, I had fun with pop ones, but they're really this big. What else can it be? Let's go see.
I'm supposed to go home for dinner.
Oh, who cares about that? Are you afraid?
kisses?
I'm not afraid of anything. Prove it then. Follow me.
Little did Widget know
that her life is about to change forever.
I find a diddle. Frillet. Orfeedy. Orfeedy. I love Frillet. Swish it up.
See, I told you. Those are big tracks, all right, but I'm not sure. I'm no expert, but legit. I'm not sure that those are rhinoceros. Legit. Did you ever consider an elephant? Because I think it might be legit. Dragon!
Olo time? Olo Fiji! Olo Fiji! Olo! Olo!
What's he saying?
I don't know, but it must be something horrible. Stand back, Heratos.
What are you doing?
Don't you see? This is our big chance for adventure. I'm going to kill the dragon.
Kill him? Don't you think that's a little drastic?
It's the only way, Heratos. Prepare to die, dragon.
Brickety brat, brickety brat.
What does that mean, brickety brat?
It means he wants to eat us.
I beg your pardon.
Huh?
If you must know, brickety's dragon needs to hoop with this impudent little girl in my presence. And brat, you carry your sorry self in before I fuck you with my dustpan.
You speak people talk?
When I choose to, who wants to know?
I'm Widget, Widget the mighty dragon slayer.
Really? What a shame. When we thought your mother might have had more sense. And you, little one, what'd your mother call you?
Henry, sir, but everyone calls me Heratos.
Truly? What a lovely nom-de-plume.
You think so?
I do. White has flash and sun, but just a touch of whimsy. Pleased to meet you, Heratos. My name is Morta.
Are you a dragon?
Oh, I do hope so.
But you're supposed to be extinct.
Really? I didn't know that. I do apologize.
And you're supposed to speak in poetry?
I'm sure that's not correct.
It is.
Well, I can say there are a few times when I begin the day with a jolly roses are red and violets are blue sort of theme, but I quickly find I don't much care for them.
So you don't eat little kids?
Do you have an education, girl? Have you ever seen the entire book? Dragon for herbivores, and the thing we crave is...
Yes, yes. What do you crave?
Carrots. Horse, and so hard to find these days. Oh, yes, yes, yes. I know all the nutritional horse stories, how they make you fat and give you gas.
That's ridiculous. What are you doing in Pleasant Valley anyway? There haven't been any dragons here for years.
I know. But one must carry on. You see, I have a nice, cozy little cave over here. But sometimes I do wish for someone, a visitor.
To roast on your fire, I suppose.
Actually, I was hoping for someone to play Scabby. A nice game of Scrabble, perhaps.
I like Scrabble.
Do you? How lovely. Oh, do sit down. What fun we'll have. I just took some lemon crumpets from the oven. Would you, dear kids, care for a little munch?
You're not a real dragon. Real dragons are big and fierce and mean and scaly.
I think you're not a real girl. A real girl wouldn't sling such arrows at a new friend.
But I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
You don't know dragons or anything at all, and that's a fact. This is for you, Heratos. Give it to your mother with my compliment.
Don't take it. It's just a dragon trick.
It's a trick of kindness, Widget. You should give him a try with it. I do.
What'd you have to go and say that for?
It's just, I don't trust them. He's not like any dragon I've ever heard of.
But poor Widget feels sad and just a little confused.
Let's go home.
After all, it's not every day a boy meets a dragon who wants to be her friend.
In the kingdom, there lives a score of the country around.
An ornery cuss by the name of Scumwood.
This way, boys.
He was the leader of the pack, a bunch of rowdy so-and-sos known in these parts as a grody gossiper.
What you got there, Scumwood?
Watch this.
Hey!
Why, it's little thingy of Widget.
What'd you do that for?
Cause he's the king's son, lord of the land.
The king's brat, you mean.
Keep on rat, Frisbee.
It's Harry.
Ha ha, your name's Frisbee.
Scuzzy toenails.
Fungus piggies.
Ha ha.
Knock it off.
Why, who's gonna stop at you? You're gonna tickle me to death, little thing, no widget.
Knock it off.
Look at what he's got here.
Why, it's a little baby.
Forgive me not, it's one of those whatchacots, a love token.
Got a girlfriend, Heratos?
Leave him alone.
I got it from big, old, mean door.
A weapon?
An axe man, yeah, that's it. A great big axe man.
Yeah, it's
very, very sharp.
So you better stay away from him, because you don't know what he'll do. He could chop you into pieces and all that. Come on, Haritos, let's go home.
And he's got a rhinoceros, too.
Come on.
Let's stay away from the axe, man.
Oh, come on. You should not. What type of axe can hit our flowers?
No offense, guys.
Let's turn it up to something. I'll figure out what it is. Follow me.
Chief, what about the rhinoceros?
Oh, come on.
The two kids went their separate ways, and when Widget got home,
alright, Mother, bring on the mutton.
Now hold your horses, Angus. I have one more mouth to feed.
Mother, Father, you won't believe what I found.
Wash up now, Widget. It's time to eat.
But Mom,
do as your mother says.
I was just over the hill and you won't believe what I found.
Grace.
I found a dragon and his name is Mortimer.
That's nice, dear.
That's so. Does he breathe fire?
Well, I think so. I don't really know.
Does he speak in poetry?
Well, no.
Does he eat little girls for breakfast?
He likes carrots.
Then what makes you think he's a dragon?
He said so.
Ah.
Try as she might, Widget saw that no one would believe her.
Time for bed.
Sweet dreams.
Widget watched the full moon rise from her bedroom window that night.
It's all Mortimer's fault. He could be a real dragon if he wanted to.
So she climbed into bed.
Somebody should teach him a lesson.
And as soon she was fast asleep,
dreaming as she always did,
of high adventure.
Hear ye, hear ye, all ye of low peasant origin. The king requires all the lonely subjects to meet in the town square. Hear ye, hear ye. What are you doing just standing there? Come on, get up, show some respect. Hear ye, hear ye.
Oh heavens, the king is about to speak.
Whatever can be the problem.
It must be something very important.
What's the news? What do you think it is?
Shh, everyone be quiet. Here he comes.
Ladies and gentlemen, subjects of this great kingdom, I am your great and all-powerful king, and it is my job to do all the kingly things that kings are supposed to do. Accordingly, I have gathered you all here today for a most royal and kingly speech of great import to all. Thank you, thank you. Now it has come to our kingly attention that the kingdom is under siege.
Under siege?
Oh no.
Yes, my lowly subjects. I have it on excellent authority that we are in dreadful danger.
Oh heavens!
For we have amongst us one who slithers through our pleasant valley with great treachery and deceit, one of great immensity and utter disloyalty, one who not only trick us and deceive us, but in his hungrier moments may actually eat us.
Eat us?
This is too much.
This fire-breathing blowhard is one of that most base and vile species of creatures, a green and scaly monster, none other than a great dragon.
Dragon? A dragon.
I have it on excellent authority, the word coming straight from the mouth of my son and heir, who has seen the dastardly beast with his own two eyes.
Scumworth.
The gobster saw Mortimer in the cave.
As you all know, there is only one master, one guru in the land who knows it. Accordingly, I have sought this great teacher's sage advice, and he tells us there is only one course of action.
That's right, we must follow the guru's advice.
Yes, yes, follow the guru's advice.
Father, who's the great guru?
The dragon must be slain, and slain post haste. Accordingly, I have sent my messengers throughout the land to find and procure and bring me the greatest dragon slayer who ever lived. None other than fabled and legendary, White Knight of the Royal Steed, St. George.
St. George? Oh no, Father, you must do something.
May God have mercy on us all, I have spoken.
Hear ye, hear ye. The king has spoken.
But Father, Mortimer doesn't eat people.
He's a herbivore.
Now, kids, let's put an end to this dragon nonsense. If the prince has seen a real dragon...
Not just any dragon, a dragon!
Then it is a real dragon, and not some imaginary claptrap the two of you have dreamed of. The guru has decreed that the dragon must be slain.
And slain he shall be. It's the only way.
But they can't kill Mortimer. They can't.
Now, Widget, please don't worry. The guru knows everything. He can't be wrong.
But if the guru knows everything, they must know that Mortimer can't hurt anybody. All he wants is a nice cup of tea. He's someone to play Scrabble with.
A friend.
Ha, that's a good one.
A friendly dragon.
That's a good one. A big one.
Just imagine, his fat belly jiggling. Well, it's almost time for celebration, kids. Soon St. George will be here.
What a fight it'll be.
Three cheers for old St. George.
Hip, hip, hooray!
What are we gonna do?
There's only one thing we can do. We have to make Mortimer fight.
And off they ran.
As fast as their terrified legs could carry them.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Snooty Tooth. Hello, Mr. Rattlebum. Where shall I sit? Here, lovely. Don't mind if I do.
Mortimer! The king is sending St. George, the greatest dragon slayer in the land. He's coming to slay you, Mortimer.
Slay me? Don't be silly. I've never even met the man.
It's true. You haven't got a chance.
No one's going to slay me. I refuse to entertain the notion.
It doesn't matter where you irritate. St. George is coming, and he's going to do it.
He's quite a rude little thing now, isn't he? Going around slaying everybody without their permission? My, my. Carrot?
Well, just one.
Oh, you're a ridiculous dragon, Mortimer. What kind of dragon refuses a fight?
A very civilized one, I must say.
Don't you know anything? Dragons are supposed to tramp around the country, terrorizing people. They're supposed to breathe fire and be big and scary and awful.
So if I were an awful dragon, then you like me?
It doesn't matter what I like.
I've seen the kind of dragon that you'd like me to be. In fact, in my youth, if you must know, I encountered quite a few of these awful bullies, and they made it very difficult for me.
More carrots, please.
You see, Widget, I've always preferred a life of gentility and grace.
But don't you see? You're doomed.
Oh, let's not be dramatic, Jolly. You'll figure something out, won't you, Widget? I know deep down inside you're a brave girl with a heart of gold.
Very good team, Mortimer. Thank you.
Be still my heart. Promise me you'll put an end to all this nasty business, won't you, Widget?
And history keepers.
And as everyone knows, only those who remember the past
can change the future.
Please, old folks of Hudson Valley, how do we save the dragon from cruelty and doodling?
He was scared of the high purple ridge of yonder.
You must climb to the summits of the chilly mountains.
For there you'll find the sacred place of Master Guru. And if you pose the right question,
he may share his worldly wisdom.
But what are the magic words? What should I ask him?
How to train your dragon!
There once was a man on a mountain who spewed out the truth like a fountain. The folks all around thought his knowledge was profound, and his wisdom, it did quite astound them.
Widget, look.
Who goes there?
It's us, ma'am. Widget and Hairy Toes.
We do not know anyone by those silly names. Goodbye.
Please, ma'am, we have come a long way. We must speak to the Master Guru.
Everyone has come a long way. Kings and princes throughout the land have sought the Master's wisdom. Why should he speak to one as lowly as you?
Because we have to save our dragon.
The master advises that all dragons should be destroyed. Goodbye.
But what if the dragon's a nice dragon? What if he just wants friends and doesn't want to hurt anybody?
It makes no difference. Goodbye.
I don't believe you. I think the guru wants to save this dragon.
He's kind. He plays Scrabble.
have been waiting for you.
You have?
I observed the long history of dragons in the country, and you propose to save this last one. It is, of course, preposterous.
But why? Why do all dragons have to be destroyed?
Not all, some may live.
What do we have to do?
I have written a handbook. Follow my three easy steps. Many have traveled far to receive this gift. Only you have held it in your hands. Next year, of course, it'll be available on Amazon.
Step one.
Hold your dragon.
Step two.
Protect your dragon.
Step three.
There's nothing there.
If you succeed steps one and two, you will finally learn the secret of step three. Be brave, Widget, for this is your adventure.
Behold, my loyal subjects, the moment of glory is at hand. The great St. George has arrived!
I rise like a Zeus to your call. Only I can make the beast fall. I'll stick my spear through my barbecue, and I'm simply the greatest of all.
Hi, Mortimer.
Pleasant Valley, I've come to rescue you from your tyranny of evil.
What a ghastly surprise.
We were just sitting down for the tea. Would you like to join us?
I've come for a slaying. There's not a moment to be wasted.
Come on, old chap. There's always time for a nice pot of tea.
Step aside, good people, while I fulfill my duty.
Would you like some carrots? They're very good.
Present the dastardly dragon at once.
If you please, sir, the dragon in question is not dastardly at all.
Really? They are usually dastardly as a rule.
Couldn't you consider bending the rules just this once?
This is entirely inappropriate. I insist you end this silly business forthwith.
But sir, if you would only just meet him.
And I suppose you'd like me to shake the scoundrel's hand?
That would be nice. Mortimer? It's all right, Mortimer.
The safe could hardly believe his eyes.
Mortimer was nothing like any dragon he ever encountered before.
Good heavens, is it a party?
For you.
For me? Lovely.
Prepare to die, dragon.
I beg your pardon, sir?
I'm the great St. George.
Great, are you? And what are your other attributes? Is modesty among them?
Before long, Wedge's hot air began to fizzle from him like an old balloon.
Here's his cup of tea, if you like. It's not exactly great, but I'll think you'll find it's pretty good.
Do you have any honey? I prefer it to sugar.
Much easier on their digestion.
Yes, I find that very, very true.
Before long, the villagers could see that there would be no show.
What does the handbook say, Widget?
Congratulations, you have successfully completed step two. You have protected your dragon.
We did it.
Now comes the hard part. Step three.
Nothing.
Dustman, they can see the delegation of the king and his court climbing up the wall.
Widget, look, they're coming to get us. Let's hide.
Not you.
There it is, some kind of white knight he turned out to be.
Where's the dragon? Did you let him escape?
Your Highness, I can explain everything. This dragon is of a different sort.
You don't say.
I feel strongly that this particular dragon is no threat to your Highness.
Hello, anybody in there?
Your performance, Sir George, has been abominable. You, sir, have insulted my kingdoms. You have insulted my kingdom, and most of all, you have insulted my son, who started this whole thing in the first place.
Yeah, he started this whole thing in the first place.
I insist that you hunt this beast from its hiding place forthwith, and I want to see a jolly good show at sunrise tomorrow. Do you understand?
Yes, Your Highness.
I have spoken.
He has spoken.
I've reaped all the trouble I've caused you. My judgment was too hasty. Can you ever forgive me?
1,000 times. But what good is it to do when I'm doomed, condemned to die at sunup?
Step three. The guru, you must go to Chiyo Mountain now. There is no time to waste.
So the friends took
the path of the way. To Chiyo Mountain, where at last they came to the sacred place of the guru.
You haven't told us what to do.
Goodbye.
But Bradley, say more. You haven't told us yet.
Gadzooks, I think I got a plan.
You do? Here's the plan.
Race through the village.
Just before dawn, everyone came streaming into town square.
Everyone wearing their nice Sunday clothes and carrying a picnic basket.
For this will be the best entertainment the kingdom has ever seen.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for attending today's most momentous events. As you all know, St. George has had a good talking to and is much better for it.
You tell him, Pop.
The cowardice is over. The disappointment has been extinguished. Excitement awaits. Great people of Pleasant Valley, I give you the great St. George!
Since Comeau started this whole thing, he decides right to call the shots.
Come out of the cave, you lousy rotten dragon. St. George in this corner.
Yay!
Well, the rotten dragon this corner.
Ooh.
Let the fight begin.
Oh dear.
Don't forget your fire, Mortimer.
Your mother has bad breath.
Not him. Him!
In round one.
Huh?
Now she's dragging us done it. He's killed St. George.
Oh no, no.
St. George says the only one that can play Mortimer is Widget.
Me?
Glad you're good, Widget.
No, my baby, please don't!
Come on, Mortimer, you can do it.
I'm not entirely sure that I can, Widget.
You can.
No.
You can.
No.
Come on.
No.
Your mother has stinky armpits.
That's a devilish bump you gave me.
Oh, I do hope you'll forgive me. It wasn't from the heart, you know.
Are you okay, Mortimer?
Who, me? Never better.
So I didn't really sip you?
No, it just went through this blob of skin right here. You see, not good for anything, really. Didn't feel a thing.
The plan worked beautifully, George. I'm awfully sorry you had to lose.
That's okay. I find once the war is over, no one really remembers who won and who lost.
In the distance, they could hear the town cheering and feasting and having a jolly
time. It's always that way, isn't it?
The villagers led a banquet and a victory, and it always ended in.
And although Mortimer dearly loved a good party,
do you think they'll be having carrot?
Maybe, but they won't be having Scrabble.
And so they decided to stay near the cave and have a celebration of their own.
Oh, I almost forgot. I made crumpet.
I like crumpets. The four new friends settled down to a lovely evening,
recounting their triumph
and enjoying their friendship.
As the sun set
and the stars twinkled,
and the moon rose in a lovely sky.
More tea, anyone?
Thank you for attending and thank you for the everything you did for the kids.